Deepti Galaron is with me on the set to take a look at the papers today. Hi, Deepti.
Hi, Jeannie.
Tensions are mounting after India said it killed hundreds of terrorists in Tuesday's air raids, and Pakistan has now responded.
That's right. We've been looking at the papers which came, which the front pages which were published before Pakistan's supposed retaliation. But you do get this sense of how tense the situation is. The Pakistani Daily Dawn citing Prime Minister Imran Khan's comments that the country would retaliate to the airstrikes at a time and place of its choosing. Well, we now know that Pakistan says it's done so. They've shot two Indian jets and captured a pilot. Earlier, the Indian papers were leading with some pretty belligerent front pages after Tuesday's airstrikes. India strikes back, the Deccan Chronicle says on its front page, noting that India was accusing Pakistan of playing a role in a suicide attack earlier this month that killed dozens of Indian troops. While Times of India, another paper there, is reminding us that these are the first Indian strikes in nearly 50 years. India's avenging force, it says, or IAF, India's Air Force.
Now, a lot of opinion pieces have come out as well on these escalating military tensions between the two.
That's right. Let's stay with the Times of India and this opinion piece, which says that if Pakistan is unwilling to dismantle terror safe havens, then India has no choice or has the right to defend itself. The paper does urge, however, Indian political classes to respond, quote, with a measure of sobriety. We are in a pre-election period in the lead-up to April's Indian elections, and the writers really urging politicians not to use this situation for political gains. On that note, The Independent has penned an interesting article about how the situation will inevitably help Narendra Modi. In fact, that's what the Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan suggested, that this latest attack is for, quote, domestic consumption. A poll showed a swell of support for Narendra Modi after that attack earlier this month that killed dozens of Indian troops. And according to one expert, a defense expert interviewed by the paper, Tuesday's surgical strike was not necessary but was orchestrated for the election.
Let's come back now here to France, Deepti. A big scandal here involving the sportswear retailer Decathlon and a headscarf for running.
Yeah, it shouldn't. I mean, I think for our foreign audience, it wouldn't really even be a scandal, but this is France and there is secularism. The French retailer Decathlon was selling a headscarf that you see there for Muslim runners on its website. After a swift backlash, the sportswear brand has now had to they initially tried to defend their choice of running accessory. Now they've been forced to pull the item altogether after threats of physical violence to its shops and racist and Islamophobic backlash on social media. The Washington Post does a pretty good job of explaining why this is such a scandal in France. I quote, "Yet again, France has descended into histrionics over the prospect of what Muslim women might choose to wear. Fiercely defending their secular beliefs, critics like on the far right in particular have used the headscarf once again for to peddle their populist agenda. The Post really taking to task the hypocrisy of the idea of secularism that prohibits religious signs, and yet in France during Christmas time you see nativity scenes, Christmas trees are put up in pretty much every major town hall, and the fact that government agencies shut down for pretty much every Catholic holiday."
All right, let's change topics now to a mayoral race in my hometown, by the way, Chicago, that has produced two surprising frontrunners.
That's right. Rahm Emanuel decided not to run for a third term, hence why Chicagoans like you, Jeannie, were voting in that mayoral election. It's been a pretty bruising campaign. More than a dozen contenders set against the backdrop of the trial of a white police officer for the murder of a black man. Anyhow, history is definitely going to be made in April's runoff elections because the two frontrunners, the two candidates who will go head-to-head in April, are both African-American women. So the next mayor of Chicago will be an African-American woman. Their names, Lori Lightfoot, who's slightly ahead of Tony Preckwinkle after Tuesday's vote. The two have actually exchanged some fighting words during the campaign but acknowledged that their runoff vote will be historic for the city of Chicago.
All right, just to wrap up now, Deepti, a happy ending for a rat who was packing on a little winter weight. I think that speaks to a lot of us.
Yeah, that's right. It happens to the best of us, isn't it? It's the thick of winter. We've been eating potatoes for the last 4 months. I don't know what this rat was eating. This poor this poor little rodent got stuck in a manhole cover in the German city of Bensheim. Concerned passersby then contacted authorities, who contacted German firefighters and animal rescue units to help to free the fat rat. They had to actually lift the grate so the rat could be freed from the underside of the manhole cover. The rodent was then left to return back to the sewers. One rescuer, which I was saying something that I thought was really nice, even animals hated by many deserve respect.
Thank you, Dipti, so much for that detail along with that look at the press review. Don't forget, you can get a closer look, of course, at the press review on our website, the address france24.com.